All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. So, got a break in the weather here. So I want to take this opportunity so I can center these holes, fix up some of the end pieces, get these pins that much closer to being ready for sale. So, as you can see, this one here needs to be centered a little bit. I think I need to flatten out this end here. This one I think just needs to be centered a little bit more. This one just needs centering. I need to flatten that out. This one really needs to be centered or flattened out on the end and centered. This one, I think we need to flatten that out a bit. That one I gotta replace the tip. Center. And flatten, I think, this one. This end, I think I need to flatten and center. Actually, I think just center. No, flatten and center. This one here, I think just center. So, we're gonna jump into this. Right, first of all, I gotta replace the sandpaper on here. This is nasty. And old. Oh, let's see. Alright, so first time doing this, so I'm not entirely sure what I'm doing, but it shouldn't be that difficult to figure out. There we go. Gold. There we go. Just super stuck on that. Oh, can you stop, please? Good Lord. Oh, that's not gonna cause a problem. That used to be 80 grit. Now that's like no grit. That's gonna take too long. All right, so we're running the Diablo Stick Fast, basically a sticker, at 120 grit. Peel that sticker off. All right, that was relatively painless. Got that changed out. Now, pull this broken tip out of here. Well, actually, not yet. So basically how we're gonna be doing this is just kinda working work this side and the top of it. So let me go get some ear protection and we'll be right back. Okay, we're back. So real quick, just want to reiterate, so of course got the iPro on and it's a little foggy. Hopefully I can fix that. Ear pro, third thing you want to make sure when you're working with especially a sander, that is way too loose for me. I can talk and we'll figure this out at the same time. You want to be very careful, because at the speed that this is turning, you may end up taking off more wood quicker than you realize. And once wood's gone, you can't put it back. So. Oh, let's see. plier size. In other words, I don't have the right Allen head for it. And actually, that just may not be able to. All right. So it looks like oh, that should be, that's better. Okay, so like I was saying, be real careful with how much pressure you're putting on, how much wood or how much pressure you're putting, and really pay attention. That way you don't end up taking too much off. So yeah, let me take that out. Let me smooth out the surface, flatten out the surface first. Go. All right. Need power. Somewhere. There we go. Okay. Can't have those there. All right. So once we get rolling with this, I'm not going to really stop between pins. I'm just going to roll between them. See how many of these I can get done. You know what? Use a little bit. All right, so here we go. All right. Let's go ahead and start with the branch. Let's see. Got 220 grit sandpaper here. Do a lot more of the job than the 400. That way the 400, all it has to do is knock down a lot of the real fine spots, or just fix the grooves that the rougher sandpaper creates. One thing you want to be careful doing it this way with the clamps is if you tighten it too down, you can't actually make marks. Tighten it too down too much, it will actually mar or put flat spots in the wood that you will have to deal with. Thinking about it, guys, I don't think I'm gonna go to the 400 grit. The reason being is I like them personally. I'm gonna do some talk to some diamond painting experts, I guess, and see what they like. But I find that, if I go with a 400 grit, it's too smooth. And it's almost too hard to, or too slippery to hang on to. So I think this 220 grit is actually smooth enough that it's smooth, but not too rough that it's uncomfortable. So, yeah, I like that. I like it. So, that's my plan right now. I keep wanting to blow the sawdust off. Kind of hard when you have a mask on. And for those of you new here, the reason I wear a mask, even besides the fact that it's recommended when you're woodworking, is the sawdust aggravates, I guess you could say, say my post-nasal drip. So that's the reason I wear it. When sanding, even shows you right here, when you're sanding, it does recommend you wear a mask. That's just so you're not breathing in the sawdust. I mean, it's entirely a preference up to you. I definitely recommend it. Okay. This is where the fine touches come in. Make sure there's no real hard square edges. That you're gonna feel. But at the same time, some of that might be the grain. And that's kind of like, it's kind of what I like about sanding by hand is you're not able to knock down everything, so it makes each pin individual. So, I screwed that up. All right. Pause, please. Just had to touch up the straightener part. When I dropped it, it flattened out an edge, so. All right, that guy's done. Let's just take this out of here. All right, this one here. Actually, I don't know if we're gonna put it in there. The 220 is working better. Well, better. The 120, when I was using that to give myself a little bit of that rough spot at the end of the pins, the 220 is, it's not making it as noticeable. So, like I said, it's doing a pretty good job of keeping it smooth while at the same time, it's not making it so smooth that it's slippery. Hope that makes sense. As so many YouTubers say, words are hard. Especially when you're trying to translate them from your mouth and your cranium to words so that other people understand them. So, almost happy with that. All right, let's knock down this edge here. All right, I like that side. It's getting a little warm right now. All right. Actually, I don't even really need the ears on, but ears. So for those of you who don't know or don't use Ear Pro, which are your hearing protection, and my job, we call them ears because they go over your ears, or Ear Pro, short for ear protection. I don't really need them right now, but as I said, they are kind of keeping my ears warm. So I don't have to, just had to take my beanie off because it's getting warm out here. I do also have 3 shirts on. So, all right, quick once over the whole thing. All right, that one's done. All right, may have to go in your home. Okay. Make sure to take that. Thank you. All right. Actually, this one I do want to put in here. So I want to hit these grooves again real quick. Just because they're a little wavy, which I don't get. All right. Let's see if hopefully this 220 can knock some of those grooves down. No, interesting. Okay. This is going to require, because this has a harder wood, so thank you. Three down. This one will be real quick because it's freaking pine. That's a softer wood. Let's just stick this sucker in here. Come on, stop moving. The pine you gotta really be careful with because this stuff will dent real easily when you got it in clamps like this. If you clamp it down too tight. You know, like I said, it's not a big deal, just a little bit more sanding you're gonna have to do to fix that. Fix those flat spots. New piece. The only reason I'm going to a new piece is that one is contaminated with the color of the other wood. So it's just leaving red sawdust on here. Knock down these edges. Edges I want knocked down. So the tine retains a lot of its natural grain. As far as kind of difficult to stand out. But that's also kind of one of the things I like about it. Is it's is each pen is truly individual, because the grain keeps its shape and feel. Four done, and the last one. And I put a hell of a flat spot right there. Ah. Cheeto dust! Forbidden Cheeto dust. Thank you. All right. Screwed up that end. I mean, it still works, it's just not, don't really like the look, but I'm sure someone will. All right, guys, and on that red note, no, not yet. I lied. Not done yet. Just a little bit too hard of an edge for me. All right, that's it. Now I'm done. We're all red and orange and white's probably 'All right. So on that note, thank you all for watching. What else? Well, I think that's it. We will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this process. I'm getting excited. I'm just going to test these pins out. By the time this video comes out, I will have already tested them. But then just got to stain them, seal them, and ship them. So, once again, thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed this. And we will see you in the next one. Peace.